two more taken back around the right.
Spanning more than 15 successful seasons and covering the country from Florida, North Carolina, Iowa, Ohio, Oklahoma, California, and Virginia, this is League One NCAA Football. This is League One NCAA Football.
What's up, everybody? Silent Gaming coming to you live here with some League 1 college football action. As the 24th ranked Duke Blue Devils get ready to face off against the 0-5 Virginia Cavaliers. And so Duke looking to try to ride their momentum to continue playing the way they're playing, continue the hot streak that they're on so far this year. Like we said in the description, off to the best start. Duke off to a really, really hot start, and as well as Coach Short's best, myself, obviously, my best start ever in League One history. So, you know, excited to, you know, to be playing the level we're playing right now. Going to try to continue on this revenge tour, like I said. As last season, we got absolutely embarrassed, dismantled by this Virginia team. I mean, it was a blowout, like 60-something to 14, 20. It's something just little to a lot, or lot to little. So, you know, we're really looking to come out here and take care of some business. We got one check already in the Florida State game, first game of the season. We have quite a few more left to check, and this is one of the games that's on the schedule that we want to check and take care of. So, yeah. So, we're ready to get this game going. Probably going to have a lot of calm silence, mic calm silence, due to, obviously, if you could probably hear in the background, the Desperate Housewives coming on. My wife's watching TV. So I'm going to stay pretty silent on the mic so you guys don't have to listen to Desperate Housewives while the game is going on. So, as much as I know you guys probably all love the Desperate Housewives so much. But, yeah, I'll try. I'm going to stay silent. If, you know, I see a couple of you guys in there chatting. I might kind of, you know, unmute it to say something to you guys real quick. But it'll be a constant mute unless need otherwise. But without further ado, we'll go ahead and get this game underway.
Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The Cavaliers have felt the brunt of this losing streak, not only on the field and in film sessions with the coaches, but pretty much everywhere on campus. You fall into a losing streak like this, and it really just takes the energy and drains the air out of the whole place. They need to get something to go right and it would be very beneficial if that happened early in this game. That does it for us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Enjoy the game. We'll see you at the half.
Coke Zero, real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Lawrence has the ball teed up, and we're just about ready to get this one started. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 10. He's tackled at the 19. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Pickup on the slant route from the quarterback. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. To about the 27-yard line. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Bring him down around the 34-yard line.
Brad, it's a first down, and obviously this offense right now is trying to maintain possession, trying to get some rhythm going, and for them to be able to pick up a big first down right here allows them to continue to try to get to the position that they ultimately want to get, and that's into the end zone.
From their own 34-yard line, first down. Decides to slide. White gets 6 yards after taking it himself on the option. Second and four. Ball on their own 40.
He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
From the 42-yard line, it's first down.
Three down, three down.
is taken down right around the 34. From the 34-yard line, it's second down. And they make the stop around the 33-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. That'll make it third and one.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. He's scrambling. Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete. That'll bring up fourth down. What do you think they'll do?
I don't know what they'll do, but I think they should just kick the field goal. It's early in the game, so I'd take the safe 3 points.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. They come out in an empty backfield. Sends it out quick, intercepted.
The linebacker here does a good job with his instincts and getting in the path of the receiver. Boy, what a great play.
From their own 30-yard line. First down. And he's immediately tackled.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back the pass.
Taken down at the 48. In the shotgun and five wideouts. He's tackled around the 43-yard line.
You don't always need to throw the ball with a lot of zip, although it does help in some cases. When you have accuracy like this guy, you can make all the throws.
Run up the middle. He tackles him for a loss. The quarterback tried to do a little too much by himself.
Hey, maybe next time he'll get. Here comes the boom, ready or not. Here comes the boys for the sack. These guys were ready for the pass and played it well to come up with the deflection.
Kicks away. And it hits the crossbar, no good. And it's off the crossbar, no good. And it hits the crossbar, no good. And it's off the crossbar, no good. We've got a first and 10, ball on the 48-yard line. And he's tackled at the 45-yard line. That'll make it second and 7. Second down and 7. Ball on the 45.
Three down. 51, Mike. Mike 51.
Go 9.
He's got it out to his tight end. Tackle made at the 21.
Change of quarterback, Kirby. Got to wonder what that's going to do to the team morale. It is next man up. They've got to be ready to trust this guy.
From the 21-yard line, first down. Garrett gets about 4 yards on the play. Second down at 7 coming up here. Ball on the 17-yard line. Brought down at about the 23-yard line. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Tackle around the 13-yard line. They complete the slant. Good for 10.
That'll make it 4th and 2.
So at the end of one quarter, this one's scoreless.
Quick update now. Here's Reese.
Time to enter Blacksburg. And for Pittsburgh, they seem to believe that 3 things can happen when you pass, and 2 of them are bad. Most everything that happens when they run is good, including this touchdown. Pittsburgh's on top, 14-7.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here. momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Gets out to around the 35. And that'll be a gain of 10 by the running back. Gains his way to midfield. And they get nice yardage on that run. Tries to get around the corner. Hands it off. Makes it to the 37.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air with a play-action pass.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
Getting the turnover would have been really big.
Virginia is looking to tie things up. It has the distance, and he missed it right. No good. So they come up empty-handed there.
Kickers have to have a short memory. Just go out and make the next one.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Play fake. Here comes the defense. They'll make the sack. Third and long now after the sack. Dangerous throw. This one's picked off. They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line. The defense now has 2 interceptions in the game.
I think there was a miscommunication there on the offensive side of the ball. I think maybe the receiver ran the wrong route, but regardless, still great play by the defense.
from the 32-yard line. It's first down. Takes a hand up, but brought down before it could go anywhere.
Did you see how that big defensive line got such a quick push on the play?
From the 34-yard line, second down. Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage.
Here comes the boom, ready or not. Here comes the boys for the sound. Here comes the boom, ready or not.
Down now, and they need to get it to the 22. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. He airs it out.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. He put his defense in alignment in a position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Virginia can tie it up here with this kick. The kick is away. It's long enough, and it sails right on him. No good. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
Let's take a look at this traditional MAC showdown. And for Eastern Michigan, they get into the end zone first through the air. The Eagles are on top 7-0. In another game, Atlantic Coast Conference action in the spotlight. This is a game we've been watching closely today. We have got an all-out Donnybrook on our hands. The Panthers are on top. 7-4.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possession. Duke holds the field goal lead. He's at midfield, makes it out to about the 49. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 49. Up around 5 yards with that catch.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
Second and six. Ball on the 44-yard line. He's at the 30, and down he goes, around the 23-yard line. From the 23-yard line, first down. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
I mean, he has his wide receiver wide open. You spend all those hours during the week to be able to get prepped and ready to go. You got an open man like this, just step and deliver and make the throw.
So it's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 23. Duke is up a field goal.
All right, so Coach Mike back on. Wife is done watching TV, so we'll go ahead and get the coach mic'd up again.
He makes it out to maybe the
making a lot of mistakes so far. There's some really stupid passes. So we got to get it back under control. Just be smart. Just forcing things. I'm just not playing my game, and I've been not playing how I normally been playing. And we're getting really lucky. I mean, I'll give credit to my defense playing good, but we've been getting lucky.
The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Looks for his tight end over the middle, and they make the stop right around the 16-yard line.
And the way this game has been going, gotta get any point we can get. We're gonna keep getting lucky.
It's up, and they tack on 3 points. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
Yeah, I know we got plenty of ball game left to get it figured back out. We gotta get it taken care of. We can get back to our game plan. But they've been playing all season, not what I'm having playing right now.
20-17.
All right, Reese, 6-0 in this one. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. Well, it's always fun to be part of a defensive battle, and that's certainly what we have right now.
Yeah, give credit to both of these defenses.
Just defense. Keep my defense. You keep playing the way they've been playing. They're playing great. I mean, credit to the defense right now. They're the reason why we're still winning. The only reason why we're winning.
With so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just
this right tackle there, though, is their like best lineman. Someone had a hard time trying to get off blocks and freaking.
He's under pressure.
Yeah, so you can't give him that much time. Cannot give him that much time. It's true, I heard you switch up sides because I don't think their left tackle is as good. Oh my gosh, not only did he catch it, he like got off the tackle? Wow. All right, Long, it's time for you to have a good game. See if I can get this guy on skates. Ah.
Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds.
Yeah, come on, D. Oh, I got it next quickly.
Ball on the 32-yard line.
Oh my! And I get a freaking.
Might be a holding call.
No, I'm getting a roughing the passer. Oh my gosh! I finally get in there, and of course.
Right there, the coaches will be giving them an earful for it too.
This will be the time that we.
From the 17-yard line.
Give him freaking points down for the first time.
He's tackled around the 16-yard
line. I'm really surprised they ran the ball.
On the run.
You have to like
that's kind of why I went in the zone.
Able to move up quickly and bring down the ball carrier for a short gain. Nice stop by the junior.
Because I was like, I don't think they're going to run it. I mean, they were in a formation that screamed run, but...
pitch.
What's that?
For a loss. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown.
Oh, yeah.
Let's find out.
Oh, yeah.
That penalty drive.
Push
them
back.
And they're shooting themselves in the foot.
Push them back.
They can just keep their concentration.
That was Dookie of the bluest like of devils.
Second down and a ways to go because of the penalty. Incomplete, and that one probably
yes.
should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around.
I don't even know who he was trying to
somebody
throw it to, honestly.
Had to be open.
Yeah, we're putting that left tackle on skates. He can't. Get him on skates.
We got the ball here. They come out of the empty backfield.
Ah, of course not this time. Get off a block. Jeez.
Well, they dug a bit of a hole for themselves and were forced into a low percentage pass play
yes.
here on third down. But the good news is
yes.
they still have a shot at some points.
Oh, crap. Oh, well. I highly doubt he misses this one. He's not going to. There's no way he goes 0 for 4.
It's up. Yeah. Looks long enough. And he splits the uprights. Lawrence gets set to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. Tackle at the 17.
Dang it. We all got a block, man.
Has the ball. They're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've
all
been
right,
facing.
White. I'm
going
to trust you.
How they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
And you're cold, though.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possession. They come out in a five-wide set. He's on the run. Now he's going to run and watch out. He's out to the 30. He steps
there we go.
Out the 37-yard line.
There we go.
Their own 37-yard line.
I almost thought my play clock was
it's
running. I was
down.
Like, oh, I went out
Duke
of bounds.
Is up by 3.
Face mask. Yes, give it to me.
Right
give it to me. Thank you.
They're giving
give
away
me the free yards there, bud.
Really making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
Give me the free yards there, buddy boy.
From the 43
34
line.
Seconds, three timeouts. It's like an eternity.
He's scrambling. He's under some heat. Heading for the corner.
Oh, what a block. What a block, Newsom.
The 28-yard line.
That's a freaking block right there. That is a freaking block. Fortunately, with the one quarterback situation,
first down.
Gonna have to run. But I got three timeouts, so.
There he goes. And they push him out at about the 15.
Hey. And we get out of bounds? And we get out of bounds, boy. Save the timeouts.
The 10. Tackle at the 6-yard line. Duke's going to use their first time out of the half here.
Well, they just stick
it's
with the freaking.
Down now. They're just a few feet away.
This right now. Let's go punch it. Let's get in a touchdown right here, boy. And that's a face mask. Is that not a face mask?
This offense right now is working exactly the way they had planned all week long. You put in so much time as an offensive coordinator, as an offensive staff.
I really want to, like,
might work. You put it out there and you wonder.
I'm gonna chew a little bit more here.
Right now, this offense doesn't have to make any adjustments because their plan is working perfectly.
The Blue Devils call a timeout. That's their second of the half. First and goal from the three.
Yeah, the one more timeout.
Duke has a three-point lead. Brought down around the one-yard line. The Blue Devils using their third and last timeout. Here's the eighth play.
Basically got something quick.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers.
There it is. Let's go.
For the touchdown.
Yes. Huge touchdown right there. Just what we needed.
He's taken down at the 42.
Just what we freaking needed. Let's go.
Duke's got a 10-point lead.
Oh, man, dude. I'll be honest. I'm really happy to have a 10-point lead with how the first half was. Because we were not playing very good. I mean, I'm just making dumb passes. A lot of, like, just forcing things. I've been playing this whole year. I've had this motto. And any of you guys that follow me on both the leagues I'm in, League 1, one star. I've been playing this motto that I need to be more afraid of turnovers than anything else. I need to be deathly afraid of turnovers. And I've been playing this game not like that right now. And, I mean, 1-for-5 on third downs, 0-for-1 on fourth downs. I've barely used any fourth downs this year, and I finally use one, and I don't get it because I force something and get it picked off. Like, just stupid stuff. Like, not playing the way I've been playing so far this year. And we're 5-0 for that exact reason. I've been playing to not force things. I've been playing to play the momentum and not turn the ball over and all those kind of things. And so right now, to have a 10-point lead at halftime, I'm very grateful for that, because we've just not been playing very good. Not playing like we've been playing all year. So, I should say on offense, defense is playing great. I mean, jeez. They got them 0-for-4. They haven't converted the third down yet. The three missed field goals, I mean, that's kind of lucky, but because if they get all three of those, I mean, you're talking about it's 12-13. So, I still have the lead, but it'd only be a 1 point. It wouldn't be a two-possession game. So, just getting really lucky that we have the lead. But that is the first half. Second half is about to, you know, we're about to have the second half here. So, we just need to continue to play like we have been on defense and get the offense rolling. And I think that we can start rolling, like, big time there. This offense hasn't been too hard to predict. It's been pretty easy to stop so far. I mean, I don't want to jinx myself, but this is definitely not the same Virginia team that had to play last year. And, you know, they lost a lot of players. The quarterback is a true freshman, and he's 80 overall. So he's going to be really good in the future. So this is going to be a guy that probably gives me trouble in the years to come. But right now, being 80 overall, he's going to be a little bit lower in certain things. And I think that's hindering him for now. But we'll see. Just got to keep playing. Like as well as we have on defense, and start converting on offense, and not turn the ball over. That's the biggest thing. Just don't turn the ball over first, and then start converting on offense and defense. Just need to get more pressure. I want to get more pressure on the quarterback, and I think we might have found a way to do so. So we're gonna go and try to capitalize on that here in the second half, and hope that we can give them an ass whooping, because they whooped us last year, and so I really, really badly want to run it up on them, to be completely honest. So we'll see. Second half coming here.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Sends it sailing downfield.
I wonder if they're going to try to still come pass heavy or they're going to try to run.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
I mean, there's two broken tackles. Right, it looks like they might be coming out here in the pass. Young
quarterback of making the defense pay for bringing both outside linebackers. That's composure right there.
Watch now that I audible. Ooh, I got lucky. That was about to be a face mask.
Maybe a yard on that draw play.
Oh my gosh.
Down he goes at the 23-yard line. What a throw.
Well, here you get to see how accurate the quarterback is. He places the deep ball in there perfectly. Just a great throw.
Gosh dang it. Main reason I don't like zone is if you can't get pressure and you're in a zone, eventually somebody's going to get wide open. That brings up second and five.
Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 18-yard line.
Ooh, it might be a run. Oh, yeah.
Slings it. Touchdown, Cavaliers.
And just having the play we've been playing, and we give her a touchdown on the first drive. They come back.
And a nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
The draw within a field goal. And he hits the PAT. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
The Hokies have entered Lane Stadium. Ooh, Virginia man. Tech playing ball in Blacksburg.
I believe we play Virginia Tech next week. So today.
The Hokies have the perfect
final score is going to be big for me.
The Hokies lead 24-20.
All right, Reese, back to our game. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 10. Bounces off a would-be tackler, and he has it on the corner.
Oh!
Knocked out of bounds at the 30.
And away, Jordan.
So they're just about set to get the game going again. Duke is up a field goal. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. Second down and nine.
All right,
to go.
Boys, let's go. Let's
ball
get it.
On 32.
Let's get back to work.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And they make the stop around the 39-yard line. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker.
Well, Kirk, good news. We saw him go to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury, but apparently he's all right, and it looks like he's going to get back in the action here.
Yeah, he's all right. He's out for 6 weeks.
Fires quickly to the tight end.
And he's taken
Thank you, boy. Let's go, Devils. Let's go, Devils. Let's go, Devils. All right, boys. This punch just went in for six.
It's first and ten.
Get a
ball on
six.
The 46-yard line.
Touchdown for six. Oh.
He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
Ah, damn it. Yeah, no, Garrett. Sucks. Sucks big time. Big time, man.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 46. Duke holds a field goal lead. They'll make the sack.
I let that take too long.
They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks.
I like the play, but it's just, pulling turf out of his I got to hit RT and get the freaking. Get the doggum.
Well, they've converted one third down
play action done quicker.
Faced with a third and long. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Got a man. Watch out here. He's taken down at the 48.
Yep. Ah, dumb man. Damn. Nah, I want
to
start.
Trying
so
to
far.
Change the field position with his kick. Oh, excellent!
Doggummit.
This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback.
All right, D. Need you here.
This deficit can be easily overcome. Sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series.
That's what I get for saying something about their offense.
Their defense. Grabs it and hammered right there. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 25-yard line.
All right, D, come on. Oh, my gosh.
He's tackled at the 41.
Dang it. Big old hit coming down the line there. Who even was that on my team? Jeez, dude.
Here they come. Throws it out there.
Duffy.
And he's knocked out immediately after the catch.
Ah, Gummert. Sides. Dude, we're getting no pressure.
One.
We got to get pressure. Oh, crap.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. Throws complete. He's got room to work. And he hits him hard at the 7-yard line.
Dang, dude. This is not how I wanted to start this freaking second half. Gave him a score, and Looking like you're about to give another one. Yep. Son of a bitch, dude. Gosh damn it, this is what I get for freaking opening my stupid ass mouth. Oh, I think we can run away with this one. We can run this one up and we give up 14 unanswered there.
Virginia is up by three, and he converts the extra point. So that's an eight-play, 80-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
So our score, 17-13. He's to the 10. He's to the 20. At the 30.
Come on, Jordan.
The 50.
Let's go.
At the 44.
Let's go. Come on. We're going to go with what's working right now.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Makes it out to about the 36. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. He gets to about the 27-yard line.
I'm going to start running down their throats. Running down their frickin' throats.
Knocked out of bounds at the 20. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
First time.
This is so
Thank you.
Difficult to defend.
This is a perfect
Thank you.
Illustration of how to run the option, and it was perfect enough to get the first right there.
Yeah, I'm running this. I'm running the same freaking blade right here right now because we need to put points on the board. I need to get some momentum back here. Run it down Virginia's throat.
Nice run, and he's brought down. From the 12-yard line, second down.
Turn it
on! Looking at first and goal.
Let's go! Let's freaking go. Run it down their throats. All right, defense, let's go. Time to step up. It is time to step up right here. I just can't spell, apparently.
The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
Quick throw. Oh my gosh. That's seriously? Great job, y'all.
So at the end of three, Duke leads 20-17.
Put those fours up, boys. Come on. This past week, dude, here in One Star, I've been struggling against 0-5 teams, winless teams.
Welcome back to the action. Fourth quarter. This one will decide it. Tight ball game through three. Mark gets the carry. They go to the left for a nice game.
Yes, let's go.
The 41-yard line. Loss of two by the halfback.
And I wasn't offsides. Let's go. Huge. Huge.
Right now he wants to get this kick away and change field position.
Big time, boys.
Well, this is a
big freaking time.
Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
Beat the monster.
From their own 22-yard line, it's second down.
Gotta just finish this game strong, boys.
Caught out of the open. Brought down at about the 31.
Finish this game strong. All I care about.
From their own 31-yard line, first down. Bring him down around the 31-yard line.
No, Garrett. No. No. Hopefully it's nothing bad. I hope it's not bad.
Second and nine. Ball on the 31-yard line.
Pretty bad. He's been playing all season. I didn't have him like all of last year. He's a senior, so if he's down for a while, I mean, that could be it for him, but I hope not.
Zips it to the tight end. Tackle at about the 49.
Oh, okay. It's the rest of this game, but hey, I'd rather just defeat this just this game. Been a long time.
Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
No reason to get you hurt.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
Absolutely no reason for it. Go Devils, da 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 da. Go Devils, da 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 da. Go Devils. Your time to shine, Tatum. It's your shine, time to shine, Tatum. Hey, break this one for six. I mean, of course I'm gonna waste clock, but let's just go. Yeah, not happening. Hey, good run, though. Good run, kid. Good run, kid. Get a kid.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Get to that quickly. And he's taken down at about the 17-yard line.
Appalachian the State.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see
they get upset by Army.
He's scrambling. Room around the corner. The five. Knocked out of bounds at the 3 yard line. Virginia is going to use their first time.
I was like, why are they showing my coach call timeout?
First and goal from the three. They're knocking on the door.
Yes. Yes. Virginia Tech. That's who I play next week. That's going to be a big game for us next week. Hey, and Zach, thanks for the follow, man. Appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you. Your follow is what helped us push that in for a touchdown. So thank you. Our game next week against Virginia Tech is going to be a doozy. All right, D. Down to new defense. Yes, sir. Touchdown. Touchdown. Did you say my defense came to play when you see Virginia has two sacks, two picks, and all I have is three passes knocked down? Like, that's it. Come on. Defense. Let's get a pick. Get a sack. Come on.
Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers.
All right, Kimbrough, let me see if you do something. That right side just pretty stacked.
He's tackled around the 46.
I don't think I'm going to be able to get through there on that side. I'm going to have to just keep trying the left side of the line. That right side is
just over 2 minutes in the game.
Killing me. Yep.
If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Our defense.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line.
Yes, let's go. There it is. Put him on skates. Now time we get a sack. That's what we need there. That is what we freaking need. All right, boys, get your breather. You got to be kidding me. Wow. Unfreaking believable. You get beat on a corner route. What are you even looking at, Lewis?
And here's a quick throw.
Pick that. Oh, my gosh, dude.
He put his defense and alignment in a position.
Y'all are killing me with these drop picks. You're killing me.
They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Dude, that's like four. Oh, crap.
From the 41-yard line, it's second down. Just over
they're probably still
the
passing.
Quarter.
And face mask, not gummit. What are you doing? D, come on.
Face mask. Defense.
They're giving away 3 yards and only making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
First and 10. Ball on the 21. He's looking for six.
What are you doing? Why, like, who are you covering? Why are you even moving over to that side of the field?
Late in the fourth quarter, one possession game, and this is where Poyd.
Gosh, damn.
Whoever shows it will win.
There's literally nobody over there. Why are you not standing with him?
The draw within a field goal. And he converts the extra point.
Holy crap, dude. We're onside it.
And they could not recover the onside kick.
Well, it's a nice job there by the return team to recover the football. Now they just want to run the clock out.
Yep, that's exactly all we want to do.
Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? Virginia's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
One first down, it's over.
The pitchman will get credit for a 9-yard gain.
One more first down, and it is over.
Short yardage situation here. Second down.
I will take a knee. I ain't going to risk nothing.
A little over a minute in the game. There he goes.
Oh.
Lost the ball.
Are you kidding me? Are you freaking kidding me? I just want to press RB. That's not a fumble. He's on the ground.
Bad decision right there.
You just have to hold on to the ball at this point in the game. That play could end up being the
difference
in this football game.
He's down. He's got to be down. I definitely think he's down. Yeah, he's down. This should get overturned. Are you kidding me? It stands? Oh my gosh. Are you serious? No freaking way. Wow. Oh my gosh. I swear to you, defense.
At the 31-yard line.
They're freaking passing the ball. Get.
He's going to air it long.
Pick it. Oh my gosh, dude. Pick it off. That's the game. Dude. Like, are you kidding me? This is ridiculous. Like, now it's almost like trying to give it to him. How many freaking drop picks are we going to have? Another broken tackle, another like broken tackle after broken tackle.
Under pressure.
Thank you.
And that'll seal it up.
Doggum, thank you.
Oh, no, they really didn't need that.
Ball game. It is about freaking time.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. He takes a knee. Virginia will take their last time out. For a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee.
I want to try a 63-yard field goal. My kicker's got a boot, but I'm not doing it at the chance of it missing, and then
third down.
They return it somehow because of that crap. We're gonna go out of here with the win. Holy crap, dude.
We'll be right back.
Dude. Freaking blood pressure's up right now.
Thanks for joining us for another.
Gotta play the Duke alma mater. Oh, man, dude. Not today, Virginia. Not today. Freaking believable. I just, oh my gosh, dude. Can't believe it. Almost lost that game. I'll mostly put it on myself. I did make a lot of poor decisions. We mentioned in the first half, a lot of poor decisions there. Just, we weren't converting very well today either. 2-for-7, just, I don't know, I'm playing the best of our ability tonight, but hey, win's a win. It doesn't matter if it's ugly like it was. It was ugly. It was an ugly win, but it's still a win. So, you know, we're still going to be 6-0, 3-0 in the conference. So, you know, you got to take the ugly ones. 100% will take an ugly win any day of the week. I don't care. A win is a win. So, just defense second half, it just did not play good. We were just not really playing good. They started picking us apart. I mean, I'm playing in a freaking, like, pass defense, and we just couldn't, just because we couldn't get pressure. Like, that's the biggest thing. This is, like, one of the worst games we've had in a while about pressure. That right tackle had me locked up, and that's my best pass rusher, so it kind of hindered, you know, our defense, because we don't have the best secondary there right now. That's something that'll get better in the future, but right now it's, you know, not the best, and it showed because we couldn't get pressure, and so they were, you know, quarterback had time to find somebody. Eventually, they got open. So defense didn't play as good in the second half, but they came up with the biggest plays there. The pick to seal it, of course, huge. Glad it came at one of the biggest points of the game, but. We dropped a lot of picks today. It's, even on that drive, we had a big one we could have had, and it just dropped. And, you know, many, so many drop picks. I think we had like 5 today, 5 dropped interceptions. Even if we get like 1 or 2 of those, like those are big momentum shifters, and you know, all sorts of different things. But yeah, I'm glad we recovered from the 2 early turnovers in the first half. And the fumble, dude, I can't believe that. One, I tried, didn't try to spin. I just tried to hold RB, and I guess my finger hit the stick as well. But even then, we weren't in the spin anymore. Like, we already spun. It wasn't like we spun into the tackle. We spun. And then we're still running forward and just freaking, of course, he's in a big group. And they would call him not down. Like, come on, dude. That was ridiculous. But, hey, again. It is what it is. Ultimately, we still got our pick and still end up winning the game. So, revenge tour is still on. Obviously, it's not as much as I'd want to. I mean, they dismantled us, but I will get there. We don't have the team, the players, as of yet to really blow teams out like that quite yet. I mean, on paper, Virginia was evenly matched up to us. You know, the same, pretty much identical team. And showed here tonight, you know. So we just gotta see. Tired. We just gotta see what's what happened, or you know, we gotta play smarter. Again, fortunate to get the win. The turnover differential is -2, you know, against us, and we still won. So again, I gotta be happy that we made mistakes today and still got the W. We'll see some scores around the country. Number 14. Ohio State gets knocked off by Nebraska. That's about the only ranked team you see. Boston College beats Wake. That's for ACC, really, to me, and that's the only ACC score they showed, other than us seeing Virginia Tech. Wait, what? Oh, my. Please tell me that it... please tell me it worked. Oh. Almost got a little nervous there. I had to play it all over. I mean, I could have a better shot of not screwing up, but I'd rather just take the win, you know. Much rather just get the W, not have to worry about playing worse the second time through. Duke, 6-0, best start yet. We are now officially bowl eligible. I'll be completely honest with you guys, to start this season, I wanted just to be 6-6, so I could lose every single game. And of course, I don't want to, but I could lose every game from here on out and still meet the goal I set. And we finished 4-8 last season. We were 4-8. And right now, 6-0. So, of course, we are feeling really good about ourselves and just really like the direction that we're going right now. And hope that we continue to, you know, to get better. I mean, it's still probably, you know, tough year or two ahead of us. But, you know, we can get some good recruiting classes here this season and next and the following one. You know, we could start having ourselves a really good team. And, you know, so I'm hoping that I can continue to do what we've been doing so far all this year and push that forward in the years to come and hope that we can continue to get better. So next week, oh, no, it's not. I don't play Virginia Tech yet. I thought last year I played them back-to-back. I don't play them till week 11. Okay, so. Next week we're on the road. Go to Miami. And last year that game was, they won by like one or two scores, something like that. Maybe two or three, something like that. But it wasn't, it was a little bit, it felt closer than I think the final score was. You know, we had chances. That was actually the game I think I made the switch to put in, at the end, to put in Griffin, who's actually redshirting this year. And he almost made a comeback for us. But, I believe, or it was, I don't remember the exact score last year, but it was like a one or two score. We almost could have made a comeback. Revenge Tour is still on all these teams. They didn't really blow us out. That game was like one score, so that one will be fun when that happens. And Virginia Tech blew us out, so we'll be ready for that one. But some tough road ahead of us these upcoming weeks. Obviously, Miami has us on paper. They definitely have the better players and athletes on their team, so we might be coming in with a better record and ranked, but it's still going to be a tough game. We got to come ready to play. We really got to come ready to play that game big time. And then, I mean, it doesn't really get any easier after that. We got a 19th-ranked Georgia Tech, so we'll see what happens between this week, their game this week, and then week 9 as well before they play us. Obviously, we saw Virginia Tech 1, so they're 5-1 right now. And then, of course, we got to play the freaking champs, the, you know, reigning national champs, the 60-something in a row wins, Syracuse Orange. So that's going to be a tough one. Luckily, we get them home. Advantage for us is it's on the other side, but the disadvantage is, you know, I can't, with them being 2-1, them being undefeated, like, these games are like, if I want any hope of trying to maybe win the Coastal, because before it wasn't the goal, but after starting off, you know, 3-0 and Florida State's, that's a good win. I mean, of course you could say, well, Louisville 0-5, Virginia 0-6, and you, we beat them pretty good, but then, you know, to only win by 3 here, you know, and you'd be like, all right, let's see what happens here. But, you know, I'm definitely saying I wasn't thinking that we can win the Coastal, but right now sitting at 6-0, 3-0, that's something that I feel could be achievable for us this year. So knowing that we're going to have to play Syracuse, and that's definitely a game that we might lose. I know it's user-user, so you never know, but I just don't think we have the players quite yet to be able to match Syracuse. They're just so loaded everywhere, so it would be really tough. We gotta play good football. This is definitely this back half is definitely going to be rough. Maybe probably a little bit rougher than the front half was. So it will. We got tough roads ahead of us. So we'll see what happens. Can't wait for it. Yeah, definitely cannot wait for it. So last thing we'll do before we head out of here, take a little peek at what's to come next week in League One. Michigan State going on the road against Indiana in a rivalry game. I believe Indiana's been on two consecutive bye weeks, so that's their first week back. So I know Coach Seawack's probably Jones in the play. Obviously, we saw my Duke Blue Devils will be going on the road against a 3-3 Miami Hurricanes team. Florida State on the road against Syracuse. Syracuse is going to play their tough two opponents in the Atlantic. So, you know, Coach Spector will be watching the game film of the Duke-Florida State game from the beginning of the year to get his team ready for that one there. Navy will be at home against 3-2 Tulsa. Washington, after their trounce, like demolishing a really good, I believe it's a, yeah, ranked 15th-ranked Arizona team. They demolished them this week, or I think earlier today. They'll be back, or they'll be home against a 1-5 California team. West Virginia looking to try to stay undefeated in one of their toughest games yet against 21-ranked UCF undefeated. So they'll be putting their undefeated conference record up against an undefeated team in general. Buffalo going against a formerly led user team in Ohio, and obviously you see that that user team is doing, or a former user team doing well at a 5-0 record. So it's going to be a big game for the MAC action there, big time game for the MAC. Army 4-2, I believe. I didn't see the final score, but they were winning over a ranked Appalachian State team, so they could possibly be 5-2 next week, going on the road against Ole Miss. And that will do it for the user games. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I believe I do not see Mississippi State. So it looks like Mississippi State will be on a bye next week, as well as Minnesota. Mississippi State and Minnesota will be on byes next week for League One. Again, our spins happen every Monday. Every Monday night they do a spin, so we won't have any action for Duke the rest of this week or until the following week. But tomorrow there will be some more League One action games right here on the League One Facebook channel. You'll be able to catch tomorrow starting at 8:15 p.m. Eastern time. The number one Syracuse Orange will be going on the road against the winless Louisville Cardinals after getting demolished by my Duke Blue Devils. I expect to see Syracuse do much of the same thing there. And falling directly after that game will be the number 7th-ranked Navy midshipman going on the road against Temple, who Temple, I believe, is currently undefeated. So that game could be more entertaining than some people originally expected. So looking forward to seeing that game tomorrow. But you will, of course, be able to catch both of those games right here on the League One Facebook channel starting at 8:15 Eastern time. And the second game should follow pretty much directly after it. Tentative kickoff time is looking around 10 p.m. Eastern time. But two games, two user games to come for you tomorrow night. And I believe that is the only other games that we shall have for you on the Facebook page until we spin into Week 9. Again, thank you guys so much for tuning in. For my own personal, I might see you guys in this upcoming weekend for some one-star action. But obviously, like I said, we'll not have any one-star or any League One until next week when we advance into Week 9. So again, thank you guys for tuning in. Appreciate you all coming in. Appreciate the new follows today. And thank you all for the love and support. I do appreciate it. Like I say, at the end of every broadcast, I put in the hard work and extra time and extra work into my streams to try to give you guys the most authentic and fun broadcast as I can. And, you know, like I said, I could just literally put on the game and play and just talk, or I don't even talk. I could just play the game and do nothing more than that. But I try to throw in all the extra stuff to kind of make it a little bit more entertaining. So I hope you guys enjoy. Let one rip. I don't know if y'all heard it. But again, thank you guys again for tuning in. I am Silent Storm, as always, as the famous Coach Spector likes to say. Hope you guys have a wonderful week. Kick his ass.